Now that I've created the IP site connect radio code plug, the next thing I want to do now is to add in a GPS revert channel. To do this, I need to firstly open the code plug, and in the channel pool, I need to add two channels. These two channels here will represent the two sites. So when we roamed on site one and it wants to send a GPS update, it will do so on this channel one here. So what we could do is we could rename this channel to be site one GPS. When the radio is on site two, it will obviously send its GPS updates on site to GPS. What is site one GPS? What is site two GPS? Well, the frequencies that are in site 1 and site 2 GPS inside these two channels here are the same frequencies that are used in site 1, so this receive and transmit frequency here, and site 2, this receive and this transmit frequency here. Now that I've added the frequencies, the next thing that I want to do is to change the slot. Now, in this particular case here, what we're going to be doing with our IP site connect system is we're going to be sending voice through on slot one. So when you talk, your radio will talk on slot one. This is already defined here in the channel. So in channel talk group one, you can see there is written repeater time slot 1, and when you are on talk group 2, it's also slot 1, but the group that the radio transmits and listens to is different. So when you are talking on the radio, voice will go through on slot 1 and GPS will go through on slot 2. So you'll see site 1 and site 2 GPS, those two channels that I've added there now, they're both on slot 2. The frequencies are the same, the color codes are the same, but the slot is slot 2. Now there are two things that I need to do. The first thing, I need to come here to general settings and I need to enable GPS. So what this does is it switches on the GPS receiver in the radio. Okay, the next thing I need to do is I need to tell the radio where it should send its GPS updates to. Now, typically the radio, which let's say the place where the GPS update should go to, is the dispatch controller. So this would be a computer which would display the decode and display the GPS coordinates on a map, and this computer would be attached to a radio, which we call a control station in all the documentation. This is essentially just a mobile or portable radio connected to the PC via USB, or there is a possibility to connect the tracking application, this computer, it's possible to connect it to the MOTOTRBO network directly via the repeater. So no control station radio required. It's a pure IP connection between the computer and the repeaters. On the computer, typically you'll find there is an application, a middleware application called MNIS. And I've spoken about this in the radio management videos. So MNIS is one way of doing it. The other way of doing it is via a control station. Now, MNIS and the control station will be configured with a unique ID. And this ID needs to be unique amongst all the radios, but it also needs to be unique amongst all the repeaters. So the ID, the radio ID that you put into the repeater and the radio ID that you put into the radio must be unique, but the radio ID you put into this control station here, which is also a radio, as well as the radio ID you put into MNIS, also needs to be unique. So here, typically what I will put in most systems, what I'm doing, I will normally reserve a block of addresses or radio IDs that are reserved for repeaters, control stations, and so forth. So the normal subscriber radios, they would have a range of addresses all the way to the end. But typically for me, the first few addresses I reserve for radios and for servers and so forth. So in this case, I'm going to make the ARS radio ID, I'm going to make it number 50. So when the radio sends its GPS updates, it will send it to radio ID 50. Now it's possible for you to have multiple control stations and having each group of radios or whatever the case may be, or a certain number of radios sending their GPS updates to a particular control station on a particular channel. What this would do, of course, is it frees up that channel. So the ARS radio ID, this is a radio, or it's an MNIS application. This will be the radio which will receive the GPS updates. Or, as you will see in this case, ARS, Automatic Registration Service, is also going to get the ARS message, the presence notification messages that come from the radio. And these basically tell the dispatcher that this radio is switched on, even though the radio hasn't got any GPS signal. And ARS also works on radios which don't have GPS. They just tell the radio they're on, but the dispatcher wouldn't really know where they are because they don't have a GPS built in. Okay, so we put the ARS radio ID in. That's fine. The next thing we need to do now is to go down to the channels in the zone, so the channel called Talk Group 1. And here now we need to specify the GPS revert channel. So we scroll down, and you will see that GPS revert is still grayed out. Why? Because we need to come back up here, and when you say ARS is not disabled, it is now, and now you have two choices. On system change, so this is when the radio is changing the channel or switching between IP side connect systems, or on system stroke side change. So the radio will send an ARS message whenever the radio changes a channel and whenever the radio changes a site. So I'm going to make it the simple one on system change. So whenever the radio changes channel, it will send a GPS update. There are some other settings here which I'll come back to in a moment called enhanced GPS. But for now, let's just stay with standard GPS updates. So we've enabled ARS. If we come back down here to GPS revert, you will see that it is now ungrayed. We can put something in here. So what channel do we put in here? Well, when this radio is on Talk Group 1, it could be on Site 1 or it could be on Site 2. Let's assume it's on Site 1. That means that the GPS updates should go through on Site 1 GPS. So the channel, this channel, Site 1 GPS is this one over here, which we've put in the channel pool. If we are on Talk Group 2, so when the user changes channel to Talk Group 2, what should it send its GPS updates on? Well, it should do the same. So we should enable ARS and the GPS revert channel in this case will still be site 1, because we will assume that the radio is on site 1. What happens if the radio moves to site 2 via roaming? So the radio is now sitting on site 2. What is the channel that the radio is receiving and transmitting on? It's not either of these channels. It's on site 2. So when the radio is roamed to site 2, it's roamed to this channel here, which is inside the channel pool. So when the radio is on this channel, it should send its GPS updates on site 2 GPS.